have. Do you disagree? Do you disagree?
I think it's more they don't give away a lot in the off lane like they normally do.
That's the same thing. Do you disagree?
I don't disagree. I thought that was very funny. I mean, listen, I have had very vocal problems with Iron Talon, so you know, I will back that horse 100%.
This is like saying Jakiro to Blitz.
Okay, so so here's the thing. In my head, how I see this matchup is that Complexity will get hyper aggressive, and they're going to play off of heroes like, I think one of their drafts is going to be Axe. I think another of their drafts is going to be Furion. I think they're going to play hyper aggressive around that, and Newbie are going to do their typical conservative play style and are going to try and punish over aggression. Complexity have a chance to win, I think, off of their Axe drafts and maybe the Furion draft, simply because of the fact that they're going to bring five members to the table, and so will Newbie in that defensive sort of fight. And we saw the way that Alliance punished that, right? Especially with the Furion, that's how they actually managed to get a lead over Newbie, was because of the fact that they had that hypermobile hero. So even if you did TP, there was already a numbers advantage.
Yeah, you've been a big fan of the Earth Spirit pick this week. Very strong pick.
Especially against Phoenix.
And with Z-Freak. Yeah. How could you not love that?
Yeah.
Complexity always run... Or not always, but they usually run aggro dual lanes of some sort. This may not be any different.
Does that help Complexity, or does it help Newbie? Because I in my very, very limited knowledge, see these two as matching up quite nicely, because I think this might just be a bloodbath. These two just might go at each other.
I think it will. Complexity have to win the bloodbath and build from there in order to take this series against Newbie. While most likely, I feel like it's much more likely that Newbie are going to be able to trade blow for blow, and then they go into the mid-game the stronger team because just the way that they draft.
Yeah, we've seen their dominance, the 15 to 25, 30-minute kind of period. It's been sensational. Even when they've lost, it's been sensational.
This is why Phoenix is a really good hero for them. Phoenix is not it's not a lane winner necessarily, right? In the sort of dual lane defensive situations, it can do a lot of good things for you, but it's much more of a mid-game dominator. It's much more of 15 minutes plus, but it doesn't secure your lane. So if somebody runs aggressive into you, it's not going to win that. But that's the thing. Newbie don't need to win their lanes. That's why they play that very defensive conservative style, is because of the fact that they don't draft themselves winning lanes necessarily. They'll draft themselves situations like, I think the mid matchup is the most representative of the playstyle of Newbie. Vipers and DKs, heroes that will guaranteed get farmed but won't get get killed by
that's
ganks.
We've kind of seen the precedent set where the offlaner, sometimes gets a ward, but it's mainly focused around mid and safe lane, looking for rotations in from the kind of the roaming heroes. Because you want to secure that safe lane, especially when you've got a Phoenix who needs those levels. You need to get to level 3 and to level 6, get that supernova up and running as well as the max sunray.
Are you surprised at all by the bans that we've seen, particularly from Newbie?
The DK and the Viper, exactly what Cap just explained, is the reason why you ban it out.
It's also targeting moves.
Yep, and the Winter Wyvern on the other side, you know that they did the Axe Winter Wyvern strat. You don't want to get cheese like that at all. So banning that out is no surprise.
I think Quad Spikes and Poker would be good for Newbie. It's very disruptive playstyle that will play against Complexity desire to go, 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 and fight, fight, fight. That's exactly what Axe is all about.
So, IO for Complexity.
The IO still picked up. They had a great success with IO on the Monday in the second game where they faced Newbie, because they have faced Newbie before. And I think this is a big up for Complexity, where they have the experience of dealing with the amount of pressure Newbie can apply in the mid game. So they're coming in prepared probably better than most teams, purely because they have faced them before.
The great thing about the Axe first pick as well is that all three core players from Complexity can play it. And they can still go for a tiny for Limp if they really want to, because that's been left through the draft. It used to be first phase ban against Complexity, but because of the way we talk a lot about how the kind of drafting meta progresses through the tournament, other heroes have gained priority through it. Your Darkseer against Complexity, your Lion, your Doom, especially against Newbie. The Tiny just doesn't have a place.
I think Newbie had two options here for their 4 position. It was either Enchantress or Disruptor. I think that Disruptor was too defensive of a hero. He's a good counter to Wisp, and he can play into hyper aggression, but I think you much more likely want to be able to trade blow for blows, or even be the ones on the aggressive stance with the Disruptor because he punishes you so heavily.
You have to address the Earth Spirit's movement early as well.
Yeah, and that's not really, like, Disruptor can't really do that, right? And Phoenix will be able to cover that mid lane. We've seen it time and time again that Phoenix will sit behind mid, and that will help deal with the Earth Spirit's early roaming. But I think it's much better that Newbie went for the Enchantress here because it's going to put pressure on that top lane. They're going to be able to create space for KP, which I think is really important in this game. Beastmaster needs to come online as fast as humanly possible. It's one of the downsides of the hero is that you need at least like Necrobook 1 before you're okay, and then obviously Necrobook 3 before you hit your full stride. But if you look at Complexity, they're going to be hitting you even before the Necrobook is ready to go. And in some ways, the Necrobook is even okay for them. If it's an under-level Necrobook, that just means more units for Axe to be able to spin off of.
Super important to have a scaling support in this situation as well. You know, Beastmaster enables people. Phoenix is very good at keeping people alive, but you're lacking a little bit in the damage. Enchantress gives you that impetus.
There's the Invoker.
Will it be Corswex, do you reckon, still?
Yeah, I believe so. I think it's the best way to play against heroes that run at you entirely. You know, whether it's the Ice Wall, the Tornado EMP, even Cold Snap, like that plays against. Because look at that. There's three different heroes plus a Wisp, Batrider, Earth Spirit, Axe, who are going to close the gap with you really quickly. An instant Tornado can save that.
Earn against Wisp as well with a Cold Snap on
him. Oh, that's true. That's a good point.
So we've not seen the Complexity play Batrider this tournament, and it's most likely going to be a Swindles hero. That leaves...
So yet another hero.
Yet another hero, yep, added to the list. That leaves Chessie hero-less for the moment. How much pressure are they going to put on a hero that can scale into the late game as well? Because we've seen a lot of games with Newbie go very late if...
I think they're fine for late game personally.
They need a tower hit,
obviously, Complexity didn't feel the same though. I didn't actually think Spectre was a possible pickup here, just because Batrider and Earth Spirit and whatever Wisp combo we have is going to be able to put a lot of pressure. And I don't think there was actually that much space for a Spectre pickup. But Complexity were scared of it. I would be like, if it is a late game hero. Now I'm reconsidering. Maybe it is a late game hero. Maybe it's something like Slark for Newbie.
Or Sven? I was thinking,
But I thought it was going to be...
Sorry, for Complexity, I mean, also.
Oh,
for Complexity, they need like an early BKB plus tower hitting hero.
Yeah.
Because they got tons of catch. They can kite and fight for days, but
there's so many things that go through BKB already. You got that Enchantress you got the Roar.
Fiery Spirits and EMP from Invoker are really annoying to deal with. Because your last hero more likely than not wants to be, you know, a physical right-click damage dealer, right? Yeah. So you want someone who can buy BKB or, you know, a Manta style, something to dispel.
About Limbs Tiny. That means that they are maybe expecting Chessie to play Axe?
Oh, yeah. I think it's actually more likely that we're going to see the Wisp paired up with the Axe a lot more, and we're not necessarily going... We shouldn't be thinking about what hero is going to pair up with the Wisp too much. Like, Tiny would be that nice in-between, right? Where it's a tempo controller, but it doesn't always need Wisp.
You see, like Newbie have played it, where it's roamed and it's it's been needed.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, Lone Druids.
I still think Chaos Knight owns here.
Yeah, it would be kind of a tempo controller.
Early Armlet BKB. If you have Arcanes on your Earth Spirit and Wisp, you don't really care too much about EMP Tornado.
I think Newbie just drafted a really good lineup. I don't think Complexity can beat this. I can't think of a fifth pick that...
Even with last pick.
Yeah, they could do like Surprise Alchemist or something that tries to push this late, but I don't...
Ooh, what about PL mid?
Man, Swindles.
Swindy,
if we were talking about draft, draft is like the most like laid-back part of Dota, right?
PL mid for Lich.
This is not a laid-back Swindles.
I know, but that's the thing. Even draft, Swindles like all over the place, man.
They could still switch Chessie to the Axe and have PL mid for Limp against the Invoker. Does very well, doesn't get shut down by Ent roaming in. Scales decently, good against the Egg. Dispels off a load of stuff with Doppelganger.
Now, that's not a bad idea.
Doesn't go BKB, but...
I think that you still get run over by like 35 minutes, but it does take advantage of a lot of Newbie's problems.
He put the paper away.
He knows.
He knows.
Shiver on
He's
the Swindles
update.
He's just
trying to convince his team. He just typed, I think they know. I think it's time for the huddle. There you go. They know they have 36 seconds, meaning they can select their hero, do the huddle, and have the time they need to mentally prepare for this matchup.
That was a chuckle from Z-Freak as well. You saw him.
Could be one of those surprise Lifestealer, Phantom Lancer.
How do you interpret that body? Is it a, wow, they've really thrown us, or is it actually a, guys, I've got this. I've found the perfect hero. Phantom. I know exactly what to play. It's going to be a Phantom Assassin.
Okay.
I mean, you knew it was a curveball. You knew it was a curveball.
It had to be the way he was talking.
Yeah. Okay. So, Phantom Assassin Blur, good against Enchantress. It's a relatively good hero against like Zoning Beastmaster. It can close the gap with Invoker and Lone Druid. It's an early BKB hero. It kind of fills all of those sum of gaps that you wanted to see. It's not a pushing hero though at all. And okay. I don't think PA beats late game at all against Invoker Lone Druid.
All right, very quickly then. We'll start with you, Cap, and we'll go back down the line this way. Better draft, newbie, complexity.
Newbie.
Gareth.
Newbie.
Ah, okay. A fairly comprehensive unanimous decision this time with all three of them going the way of newbie. Let's head back to my commentary team for game one of the lower bracket. Big stakes now. Complexity versus newbie.
Thanks a lot, Paul. Yes, we are here. Complexity up against newbie. Game number one. I'm ready. I'm ready for things to get hot in here, gods.
I'm ready too. We've stripped off the jackets.
Yep.
Good to go.
Roll up the sleeves. It's business time, boys. And Swindles, man, he looked like he was convincing everyone. You saw the look on Z-Freak's face. It's like, this isn't a good idea. This isn't a good idea. And then at the end, he gave a smile and said, you know what? I trust family.
Yeah.
Family first. We'll do this. We'll believe in it. And they draft it. It's the Phantom Assassin last one.
Big brother knows best. We'll see if that's going to be the case here for Swindles. And Complexity are going to be riding the high after that last series, though. They're going to be feeling good going into this best of three, even though they're taking on newbie. But it's a bit of a surprise pick. Out of left field comes the Phantom Assassin. Not what anyone would have expected.
No. It was also kind of like the joke here a couple of months ago. It's like, can you even win a game with Phantom Assassin was the thing. And that question is posed greater now than ever before. Complexity. Can you actually win with this hero? We were looking at like maybe you sacrifice the axe, not sacrifice the axe, you fully jungle axe, you leave the Earth Spear on the offlane, you do what Complexity did up against Virtus Pro. They didn't end up going that road. Instead now we actually have like Chessie playing the hard role as the Phantom Assassin, limps over on the axe.
I'm curious
with
to
Swindle's
see
Swindle's Batrider. It's
so for Complexity, how they intend to lane this. Swindle's on the bat means that we will have
the offlane.
He'll have to go to the offlane to at least get level 2 before he rotates into the jungle. They'll give limp, yes,
because it's not the normal sacrifice here.
I guess Chessie is likely to go mid on the PA.
With the PMS up against the Invoker, can he win that lane?
Yeah, he can do quite well because you've got the Earth Spirit on your side. There's going to be rotations, rolling boulders. Enchantress, similar thing, but the way the Earth Spirit can position is on his high ground in the mid lane, so such that he scouts out the smoke ganks from the Enchantress. And the most likely hero to die there, Cole's not going to lose the PA. If they initiate and overextend, it's the Earth Spirit who goes down. So PA should at least be able to trade farm with an Invoker.
Yeah.
In mid.
So then when do we look to see the IO have impact? Because we talk about like Earth Spirit rotating in. Can you even start it? Like, as far as that top lane goes, you're running what, an axe? Like, I almost want to see the axe go into the mid lane. Because you don't want to run
maybe?
Like an axe against like a Beastmaster. Balls are going to be a real issue for the axe. Spin all you want, but you can't be in range of anything.
Yeah. And part of me thinks like the IO at least wants to be stacking a decent amount in the early game because you have the axe there. May look to stack more towards like the far west of the Dire Jungle so that he can stay near the axe to help out against that Beastmaster. But this is very much looking like a lane that KP should get a lot out. We had a really rough game yesterday in game 3 against Alliance where he's on Tide. 5 minutes in, he's still level 1 getting zoned out. But that should not be the case here with Beastmaster.
No, it really shouldn't be. We've got ourselves a small delay as players just working out their settings. We also lost Kaka from the lobby.
Looked like Chuan was hovered over his PC fixing something, so.
Yeah, it just seems to be just a small little setting thing. So hopefully it's nothing too critical and we can get into this game. But newbie.
Do you agree with the panel about newbie's draft? Like, do you favor
this? It's one of those drafts. We were discussing this while the draft was going on. And we were saying, like, every time you look at a newbie draft, you feel really, really comfortable. Because it's always something which, like, you know what, newbie has succeeded with this before. Nothing really seems like. With Complexity, you're just like, what the hell is this? Like, I'm at a buffet right now, and I don't know what dishes they've actually put. So it's a lot of, a bit of everything. But newbie always seems to have, like, this nice structure, this nice plan. You can understand what the purpose is of their draft. That's why you always had so much confidence with them. But I always worry that newbie is going to go into the problems they had yesterday, primarily. It all looks good, and then one fight doesn't really go right because they're not expecting something to come out from the other team, and then all hell just breaks loose.
Yeah, so Complexity are going to have to play that kind of chaotic, erratic style, and that's what Earth Spirit is great for. Axe is also good. It's a hero that Nubia are probably not that actually accustomed to versing. It's a bit of a niche pick that doesn't come up every single game, despite some of the buffs to Axe and Blade Mail and all that in the recent patch. So we'll see. I definitely prefer Nubia's drop, but not by like a huge margin by any means. I think Complexity have ways to really disrupt the early game of Nubia, and that's where we've seen Nubia. If you can go when you go for the kills early on, you have to make sure you bring enough heroes, because Nubia more than anyone, that like 8 to 10 minute stage of the game where you go for ganks, they'll TP their entire team. You gank their offlaner, you've got Mu as well as Hal both TPing in to turn things around. So for Cole, you always have to make sure you have 4 or 5 heroes going for kills, and Io is great for that. You've got Relocate. So.
I also want to see him add the pressure beyond like the 15-20 minute mark. As Nubia have actually done, where they didn't have a great early game, they always seem to find this space. You don't add the pressure onto them. A lot of this came off the back of like Mu's Alchemist, when he got a lot of space, and you're like, wow, there's all the money just rolling in, and you can slowly work your way back into the game. Aghanim's upgrades, handing off kind of jazz. So I also want to see like Complexity keep the pressure up. Even if you are running like a Phantom Assassin, who you need to get some early space. Like, I'm almost wondering, like, if
man, this PA is gonna be interesting.
It's like how you do it. Like, do you actually want to go like early Midas and plan for like the level 16, the level 3 crit, just to rip through absolutely everyone, stifling dagger? You don't really care. Like, it just takes off Enchantress's life. You're like, hey, balanced hero. Like,
my biggest worry about the PA is they have a terrible draft for killing the Phoenix Supernova.
Yeah.
You don't get that. You can't blink strike on
the it has to be disengaged. It's like we're talking four staffs galore, like 3-4 of them over on Complexity.
Your cores are Axe, PA, and Batrider. Three heroes terrible at killing the egg. The IO with the tether overcharge helps a little bit, but it's still a big challenge. So the Supernova.
You can't even lock him in. Like, what do you got? You got Call, Kick, Silence, and Lasso. We're not going to count Flamebreak.
This is such a good Phoenix game for Kaka. He can sit back. He can just put the Sunray onto the PA as well as whichever hero the PA is attacking in the front line. So likely the Invoker, perhaps the Lone Druid or Beastmaster if they're caught out. So Phoenix Kaka just has to sit far enough back, throw the Sunray down, throw a Fire Spirit. Once the Sunray's worn off, you Fire Spirit's out, you dive in, get your egg, you refresh your Sunray, then you've got another Sunray. So I think Kaka is going to have a fantastic time here. The one hero that can disrupt that's going to be Z-Freak. He's going to be saving either the Boulder Smash or the pull to get the Silence onto the Phoenix to stop that Sunray coming out.
I just think they actually have to dodge completely.
That's
the only way to really do it. But how do you dodge a lineup when you're running in with an Enchantress army, Beastmaster auras, and probably Necrobook units too? Then you've got a Lone Druid Bear on the front lines that's forcing down your building so you have to fight. Then you've got another Minion Summoner through the Invoker. Like,
it's scary
you
amount of push.
You could really, really force the issue. And if Invoker goes for the early fighting build, which I assume he's going to do, like you get the Necros over on the Beastmaster, so Invoker can go for more maneuverability and like ganking items. What happens if there's actually like a Quaswex Orchid build over on this Invoker? You're going to delete a hero from the very, very start.
And Complexity's lineup does not like push out waves very well. They haven't got any good wave clear. Their way of defending pushes is by just engaging, jumping in. You jump in with the Axe or the Batrider with their Blink, then PA can follow it up, burst down one hero, but if Nubia want, they just go into more of a split push lane game where you're just pushing out all the lanes, and if you're Cole then you have to fall back, slowly counter push, which Batrider and Axe are like both okay at pushing out waves, but they're not like power farmers. So
you know, if the Beastmaster was on Complexity, I might have a little bit more confidence with them because then you could be like, oh, Hawk for setup, and like we can see what's coming at us. Like right now they've got Firefly, so they can see if a Hawk can see them, and then they know, oh, our gank is over. And that's actually then like a big thing for Nubia too. They can keep dodging engagements if they can keep vision superiority. Not even just the Hawk too. You've got Enchantress, get a Dark Troll Summoner, summon up the Skeleton Warriors, have a look around, like, go and spam out. Luckily, we are back into the game now, so everything is now done, and we can get started for this, finally. Game number one of our best of three. It's the lower bracket first final. They are in the top four. I was actually sitting with the Complexity guys yesterday when they were battling out. It's like, at the end of the game, it's like, we got 5-6! We got 5-6! We're good boys! We don't have to go anywhere else! 5-6! Woo! And now they're just like, wait, we just won this game! We got top 4! We got top 4! We also had B4 across the stage. It's like, I don't, like, we
he's like, he almost said, like, I hope we lose, because, like, to quote him, Sonny was like, I don't think I can handle Swindle's ego getting any bigger.
Yeah. straight from yeah, straight the from mouth Beast of the mouth. Manager. Like we can't deal with our captain if he actually starts winning more games. I'd hate to think what would happen. Like, you'd almost have like two years worth of ego just off a TI victory if you could ever achieve it.
Oh man, could you imagine that? The passion from this guy, you've got to love it.
I can imagine it. I just don't know if it'll ever become reality. All right, so off we go into the lanes. As far as our lanes go, it will be Howl down to that bottom lane. He'll be playing up the role as a lone druid. Kaka supporting as a phoenix, but will be the mid laner. We've got Schwindels. He'll be the bat rider in for the off lane. As far as the mid lane matchups, it will actually be Chessie with that PMS early on. Z-Freak will be his rotator. Hunskin supporting as well early on. He's already got that very early bottle for complexity. And that just leaves the top lane. KP, Australian, going to the off lane. He'll be babysat by Chuan, who normally likes to get aggressive with his Enchantress. And they'll be going up against Limp, who is the safe lane Axe. And that's pretty much how our lanes roll out.
Yeah. Well, the big, I guess, main question early on is Mu going Quaz Wex or Quaz Exhaust? I slightly prefer the Quaz Wex here. I think you want to go something a bit more defensive against the laning aggression of a PA. There's a lot of kill power coming out from PA, and a Quaz Exhaust has no disengage. He goes on you, you can cold snap him, but ideally you want to have a Tornado, an EMP, yep, to kind of threaten Chessie should he go on you. And I think with the pace of this game, you've got pushing power coming out from Lone Druid, Beastmaster, Enchantress. You don't need more firepower from an Exhaust Invoker.
I really want to also keep my like my left eye at least up on this top lane. See how KP and Limp battle this one out. Who actually gets the early advantage here? Because Limp, like, he wants to force KP out of this lane if possible, away from the boars. But KP's pretty good. He can play fairly defensive here. The creep wave's going to push to him. The Axe can't hold it back.
Yeah, he should get a decent amount of farm and XP out of this lane. Has gone for a Ring of Protection. The counter Helix being pure damage does mean that the high base armor of the Beastmaster plus the Ring of Protection isn't going to deal with that counter Helix damage like it may be used to. But still, you go for the Tranquils, then you've got the HP regen to sustain.
Enchantress going to come in towards the middle lane. Hunskin, Chessie backs up far enough. The Stomp will be able to connect, but Chessie realized what was happening. That was the first smoke maneuver of Chuan. And, well, Hunskin backed up so Chessie could just Phantom Strike away. Very, very difficult to kill mid lane. However, on the other side, if Chessie blinks forward and gets to the other side of the Invoker, you're going to have that tether slow, and you're going to have Mu having Ghost walk up his sleeve.
Yeah. And Hanskin is going to go for another double stack here in the Dire Jungle. There is a ton of farm waiting for either Swindles on the bat or the Axe. Doesn't really matter which. It's more just the fact that the economic game is going to heavily favor complexity this raid. As I say that, he misses both the stacks, so perhaps there isn't going to be a two. I mean, he hit the double stack already, he missed the triple stack on both camps, but...
You gotta stop cursing the players. Limp, are you... he's got KP low, and he's gone for this early point up in Battle Hunger and the 2 points up in the spin. Hmm. So it's nice that he's at least got some kind of harassment, but Chuan, it's a dead creep anyway, it was about to time out, so he's not going to lose anything from that. But I'm actually thinking, like, it should probably be Swindles that goes up into the jungle, because it lets Z-Freak get levels on this offlane. He's going to feel fairly comfortable, because who really stops Z-Freak on this bot lane? It's a fairly comfortable lane for him.
Yep. He's always got the escape. How can he have to resummon his bear in the bottom lane? But that's okay for him, assuming he doesn't die in the next minute or two, which, without a third hero rotating down bottom, should not happen.
He still needs to find, I would say, more CS. Like, he's got 9 CS this early on. EMP, Tornado in the mid lane. Chessie, well, he's out of mana now.
Yeah. Both these players with sticks or wands to fall back on, and the Io with the bottle means he can heal up Chessie's mana pool as well.
Yeah.
Mu with just 3 CS, by the way. That's actually the big story this early game. He is getting
absolutely
beat
nothing
down mid. Big problem with the Quaz Wex Invoker is you just don't have any damage last hit with, and because he goes for a magic wand, he doesn't have like a starting item, either Null Talisman or Blades of Attack to give him some bonus damage to help last hit with. So PA with 4-man shield, currently seeing on 62 damage, Mu with just, well, 54, not bad,
yep,
but unable to get close enough to get those last hits. He's just having an off game as well. He should have probably around at least 10 CS in this matchup. But every now and then, you just have one of those bad CS in games.
He needs the rotation from Chuan to do something. That first rotation fail is probably more of a landmark moment that we gave it credit for, where Chuan's influence on the map has been fairly minimal. Bottom lane, they're going to have a little bit of a tussle route now with Kaka. Swindles right behind him. Kaka, well, there's your kick. He needs to Icarus dive himself away, but he's already ticking out.
It's Io at the top rune.
What?
Both teams committing a lot of heroes to go for the runes, and man, does Kaka play that well. He just makes sure he gets the rune. It was very close to dying, but Nubi rotating in three heroes to the top lane, and it's Mu of all players getting the first blood. He now has a first blood to go with his 5 CS. He has more farm from that first blood in 4 minutes than he does from the CS he's been getting, so that saves his lane.
How much you also telegraph the fact he doesn't want to rotate. He picks up both of
that, yeah.
He picks up both of the blades of attack, that's realizing he needs more boots. Damage before he gets his boots.
Yep.
Limp's also having a hard time. Chorn's now having an influence up here. It's the Harpy which has just dropped Limp down low and forced him into this this early salve. But he's got the Ring of Health. Limp's going to go for an early Vanguard. Life is still not that bad for Complexity. First blood happens. It's over on your IO. It gives Mu a little bit of a way back, but he still hasn't gone into double digits for CS until right now.
So we'll see what the next move's going to be. It looks like aggression coming out. Chuan, he denies his boulder or his mud golem to get the double golem. But
unfortunately for him, like yeah, with the TP on from Chessie, there is no way they want to dive this.
This is a good force rotation, though. It means the Invoker now has a easy lane to farm. The Handskin IO is there to at least leech experience, but Mu's going to get free farm while the PA is gone. So very nice pressure coming out from Chuan, even though he doesn't get a kill here.
A lot of waste of time over on Chessie. And then they just do it again.
Look at the vision. They've got Hawks on both the south and north side of this top tier 1 tower. They see everything and they want to go for this dive with Kaka having rotated up top. 2 points in Sunray, Tornado. This is a hard gank to escape for Limp.
Limp just needs to leave.
Yeah, he got out just in time.
He kind of knew this was going to happen. Without the TP in from Chessie, you would rely on a relocate, but Hanskin's still just shy of level 4. So they don't have the ability to bring in all the support and be really hyper-aggressive on the lane. And in fact, now Limp, under cover of Sunray, he's being affected by the tornado as well. Chuan going to enchant him, slow him up. Here comes Hanskin, the roar being committed as well. Hanskin needs to give more life to Limp and keep him alive. He's getting there. Now the EMP from Mu. Tether will slow him, hold him there with a kick forward from Z-Freak. KP's in trouble. Limp will get the Culling Blade off. Hanskin will be the sacrifice, but now Swindles moves over. Mu, a wonderful tornado, but the Flame Break keeps him in the middle of this fight. And Mu, he's already had a hard enough time. He just got space in the mid to try and play catch up, but he'll lose himself, he'll lose the Beastmaster, and Chuan, best of luck, untouchable, only level 1. Swindle stacking up the Siggy Napalm with the Firefly. It's actually a double kill for Chessie. The Complexity coming in force.
Yeah, Hanskin just where he needs to be. The axe staying alive as long as he did meant Nubi were just overcommitting, and it's one of those fights I'm like, this is such a Nubi-like play to go for this aggression up here.
Top lane, Limp, he's in trouble. Sunray turns on. You're so confident, you feel you got this one in the bag, but Kaka, the damage is just so huge on that level 2 Sunray that you find the kill over on the axe.
I think the big problem for that aggression at top for Nubi is that that normally characterizes their play and works out great for them, but this is one of the first times we see Hao on a carry that doesn't rotate. He wants to just sit bottom, farm up his Midas, get his Radiance timing. It's not a Lifestealer, it's not a Spectre, it's not a Sven. It's not one of these heroes that just... Normally, Hao is TPing top and joining that fight, but because he's on a lone Druid, Nubi have not really adjusted the rest of their heroes' play accordingly. That aggression top doesn't work when Hao can't rotate.
They may also just be thinking from the other side, it's like, okay, well, if we have aggression top, we create space for him, but Swindles didn't really miss out on much. Like, he TP back straight away and took a full creep wave worth of experience. But Hao tried to punish as a lone druid, but he couldn't get himself an entangle, and he was underneath a tier 1 tower. So, life's a little bit harder for him. Swindles needs to get that Blink Dagger. Limps back into farming at the moment. He actually, he's still a way off having that Vanguard completed.
Yeah, farm some of the stacks in the jungle before falling back towards this top lane, but
that's a lot of heroes coming towards him. Hanskin tethers off cooldown in 2 seconds time, but 2 seconds may be too long, and in fact it will be no. Yes, whoa. Beastmaster KP. He was not taking no for an answer. They really wanted that kill.
He was on 5 HP when that roll went out, but unless the boar right click was going to reach him, which I'm not 100% sure on, they actually had to use that roar to secure that kill. Perhaps the boar was in range to attack.
It's just a 4-man rotation into mid lane for Nubi, which, like, nets you an IO kill. And Chessie then instantly turns the aggression on Mu. He got the crit. He's got Stifling Dagger in 1 second time. He won't get the crit from that, and Mu has to go invis. They burn the mana of Mu, and this will actually force Mu all the way back to base.
He's just happy to have survived. The Invoke cooldown just coming up in time for him to get into the Ghost Walk. If that Stifling Dagger head crit or one more right-click Coup de Grace came out, it would have been a kill on Invoker and a solo kill at that. He goes for the infused raindrops on Mu to give himself some extra survivability in this mid lane against the PA.
So Swindles. Welcome to the top lane. Instantly stunned, instantly bored. But this is like the D push that Complexity had. That was one of our concerns we have with Complexity. They wouldn't be able to hold on to their tier 1 towers. But with Firefly down, the creep waves normally disappear pretty quickly. Nice farm as well for Lemwingles. He's been hit by the central stun top. Yeah, Z-Freak makes a little bit of space, however, keeping Chorn out of the fight. The boar's up, so they know when TP's coming in. Swindles, he gets himself up into the tree line. He's still being hunted by the centaur, but Chessy comes in. Crits over on Kaka. There is no Nova yet. KP also low on life with the movement for the Roar. Tries to push back Complexity. You lose your Io in the Beastmaster. The battles continue. Chessy chases towards the east. Nu being body blocked to the left. Now the call will be there. Lasso from Swindles will be committed. Z-Freak stays nearby. By PA's finish off Chorn in the meantime, and Mu now goes Invis. They didn't actually work out which way he went. The boulder goes the wrong direction. And Mu just has to weed it out. He can't TP out to safety. But it's a 2-for-1 trade off. Again, the Io, the only sacrifice. 4 out of the 5 kills of Nubi have all been on the Io.
And again, we see Nubi, their aggression at this top lane. The hero they initially go on surviving. Last time it was the Axe. This time it's the Batrider. The EMP not latching onto Swindles meant they didn't have the damage and the mana burn. And that really cost them there. This is still all space for Howe to continue farming. He's at this True. Bottom lane, has Midas, has 1700 gold. So if you're looking at like the newbie side of things, yeah, the aggression isn't going as well as you'd hope for, but at least there is that plan B, the backup plan that is Howe yep. farming away.
But they have to be ready to deal with the double blink daggers which are arriving for Complexity. As Lim's going to farm up this Ancients after he stacks it, he'll have his Blink Dagger and Swindles. He's about to stack up as well. He's actually looking for the double stack until the tree line spawns on him the second he attempts it. It looks like he'll still be successful, however. But with this farm, the double Blink Daggers are up, and we're only going to be 12 minutes into the game before they look for a fight.
Yeah, double blinks on these two cores is very scary to deal with. This is where their timing is coming pre-Radiance. So Cole will be looking to even send aggression down towards his bottom lane. Force Howe either to fall back to his jungle or and take this bottom tier 1 tower. If you can push bottom as Complexity, you not only limit the Lone Druid's farm, but you take over this Radiant jungle, potentially setting up additional follow-up kills.
I love how one Stifling Dagger can actually remove a quarter of the life of Mu.
Yeah, it's brutal.
That just happened to him in the mid lane as Chessy, like, it was always one of the nice upsides about like Phantom Assassin. The fact that even if your lane was going bad, you could farm with like a 15 mana cost Stifling Dagger, which is capable of doing like terrible, terrible amounts of damage.
And the new changes to Stifling Dagger do mean that this spell scales a lot better as the game drags on.
This is what you're actually forced to do. Use Sunray to heal up Mu. So Kaka does this in the tree line, doesn't show it to Chessy.
Yeah.
Nope, and Complexity are actually on the hunt. They got their first Blink Dagger up, so the brothers will team up, and they are looking for the Lone Druid.
Hal's like Spidey senses tingling. He's like, okay, they've got to have that. This is just him understanding the timings of Complexity. He knows that it's about that time where these Blinks are going to come online. He doesn't even finish the Ogre Camp. He's already transitioned even deeper into his own jungle, partially to use the Midas on the big safe here, but he has completely eluded this smoke gank with the Blink Daggers. Great understanding. And the big reason this works is because Nubi have aggressive vision. These two wards in the Dire Jungle, less about setting up kills, but more about scouting out the fact that Bat's not farming the jungle. If Batrider isn't farming these jungle camps, where is he? He's trying to gank your Lone Druid.
Complexity realizes something is awry. Then pulling back over on Limp as well as Hunt's going to get back past the tier 2 tower. Chessy's now actually moving. Okay, they even put an observer ward between the tier 1 and tier 2 tower. Complexity are looking towards that mid lane to try and find out where Nubi is. They know they're smoked up. They're scanning around as well, Nubi, trying to find Complexity, but they find no one.
Yeah, this is great for Nubi. It's Howe who has rotated all the way up top. Doesn't even try and stay in this jungle. This is just great awareness and rotations from Nubi avoiding these Blink Daggers. You've had the Blinks up from on Limp as well as Swindles, and they're yet to find that pickoff. They're just kind of sitting around idly in the enemy jungle and around the mid lane, and it's Nubi. Yeah, they're also kind of grouping up as 5, not farming all that efficiently, but that favors them because they want to just slow things down, not give Complexity the fights they're trying to initiate.
It looks like they're actually going to give them a fight. It's a full 5-man maneuver towards that tier 2 tower. And Complexity, it's the question now, do you want to react? Limb can be relocated up. Swindles is on his way. You've also got Z-Free coming out from the tier 3 tower on the top lane. So they're preparing themselves to fight Chorn's Enchantress army. Plus, their observer was they've got aggressively planted down, does see a lot of this.
and have forced the rotation. They're still not fully committed to Complexity because they're actually creep skipping it. Now they've got to. Where's that relocate? The TPs are on the way, but Swindle's already burst down. Tizzy comes into the front lines. He'll be pushed back out by the Savage Roar. The Phoenix Egg right in the middle of Complexity, but the Tornado! They need to hit it! They bring down the Nova! They want to have that to fight with, and now Tizzy can go ham. He looks for the kill over on Chuan. Takes a little bit longer to hit with the Flame Break and the kick. They find the pickoff. KP successfully TPs out. So the tier 2 tower is defended, and again, Io, the only casualty.
No, no, the bat died and fought back.
Oh, he fought back as well?
Yeah, that's actually a great exchange for Nubi. They just lose their supports there. That almost goes incredibly well. If that supernova goes off, it's a heavily won Nubi team fight. But even with the Phoenix and the Enchantress dying, Nubi are so happy about that. Their cores get out of there. Hal's already back to farming, picks up his relic. The TP bottom from Mu, he's going to continue his item progression. And Complexity commit a lot of resources. Yeah, they defend the tower, but they don't get anything really out of it. They don't get to transition into a push off of this.
So overall, Nubi come out very happy from that one. They're going to have to kind of quickly go into kind of some aggressive play into the Radiant Jungle. They've got Vision down bottom, as well as the mid lane. They need to use their wards to find kills, to find pickoffs using their Blink Dagger.
Chessie's coming for a kill now. They find KP. He'll Stifling Dagger, gives the Vision to go up. Kaka is going to try and keep him alive, however, with that Sunray. KP around the corner. The Observer was there and a perfect kick, actually stopping KP from getting the Roar off. And Swindles, he wants more. Blink Dagger's on cooldown. They're searching for Kaka, but Kaka, he had an Invis rune sitting in the bottom river. So he is perfectly all right, and they can't work out exactly what the hell happened to him, but now they dust over on Moogle, who's able to reach it. Swindles keeps that Vision up. The Firefly will wear off at the moment. EMP Tornado creates a little bit more space. Mu into that tree line, and now he'll go Invis, but the crit, the damage is there. They bring down the Invoker.
Yeah,
Complexity
Mu
finally finds something on the map, but still, our farming.
Yeah, a bit sloppy from Mu, letting them rotate towards bottom. Like, he knew exactly where they got the pickoff on Beastmaster in the jungle, and then he just stayed too long in the bottom lane without a TP. He was pushed up, he had to fall back to the shop to buy it, and that's much better for Complexity. They get a pickoff, and they're able to get a tower to follow this one up. The trade-off is some farm and Hal finishing his Radiance up top, but overall, that's the kind of exchange you're hoping for in that position for Complexity. But it's really the first big win for them all game long. Up until now, it's been a bit of a kind of trade-off where Nubi are getting slightly more.
Hello, Chuan. Called out inside the dire jungle, but there's a lot more help coming. Hanskin is going to relocate in, but the call, absolutely perfect from Limp. Locks in two. Culling Blades one. Hal still in the neighborhood, but it's Kaka, who's dying a little bit further down. He actually is forced into the Nova. Swindles, I don't think he can actually finish that one, but Hal on the top, in the top river. Chessie would love to fight him, just needs an extra crit, and there she is. Helps to get the kill. Phoenix Egg burn, Mu only back to life and farming at the bottom lane, but another three quick kills coming in for Complexity.
And just Limp with the fast blink call, preventing the Beastmaster getting the Roar off, meant that Nubi just weren't getting their big spells off. And Nubi getting caught split up here, they're very much, when they were pushing that top tier 2 tower, the reason that works out so well for them, they get that great trade where they kill the Batrider, they don't get the tier 2, but they fall back and only lose their supports, is because they're grouped as 5. Complexity's lineup is fantastic at picking apart heroes when they're by themselves. You've got the relocate, you've got the two blink initiators, you've got this PA who's a good gap closer as well. Nubi have to go back to what was working, which was just much more slow pace, stick as 5 when Complexity missing from the map, and then fall back and farm when Complexity come to defend their towers. But Complexity finding some great initiations there and managed to start pulling ahead a little bit.
And looks like Complexity will try and use that newfound strength to go even further. Chessie's lining himself up for the mid. Also, looking at him, currently walking around with a Claymore. Is it just the bonus damage for now when he goes into a Battle Fury, or do we think about...
I think Battle Fury is a fantastic item because you don't have good wave clear. Your lineup isn't going to scale great into the late game without a Battle Fury, so I think falling back for it after the phase drums is the right call. Oh, they smoke up and sneak their way into Roshan. This is likely to go completely undetected.
Complexity, they don't actually have a scan available either, so they can't look for this.
I think they just, yeah, they just use their scan behind like the mid-tier one tower, I believe I saw. And there's this Radiant Ward scouting out the smoke. They know they could be coming their way, but they'll finish Roshan time and they can take this team fight if
they want to. Swindles gets the Firefly, and there's a jump. He grabs Mu, the roll will be there. Swindle sacrificing himself, they get the call and the kick. Keeps Chuan out of the fight, killing off Mu as well. Can they have enough damage for this Z-Freak on the front lines? The bear is ripping him apart as Hal wants to go to work. The Nova as well from Kaka, stunning up over on Limp. Limp will fall as well. You burn the Aegis, the Immortal. And Chessie, can he do more damage? He wants to kill off KP. He's having some real issues. as he keeps getting hit by the fairies. As Chessie, there's a blink away, down to the river, swindles. He'll die from the fall of the tornado. And Complexity have lost multiple heroes, but they do burn the Aegis of the Immortal. And they keep Chessie alive, so maybe not a complete loss, but still newbie. They take an advantage.
Yeah, not a complete loss. Mu had to buy back as well, but that's the kind of team fight which newbie will take any day of the week, considering they were behind by a couple thousand gold. They get the Roche money. They're going to fold up with a tier 2 tower as well. And Axe and Bat, neither hero with buyback means that there's no feasible way to defend this for Complexity. Chessie is just dominating these team fights. They have no real good way of killing off the PA.
If she actually gets a Battle Fury and a BKB, like, newbie are going to have real issues on their hands.
Yeah. It was really well played by the IO plus PA. They managed to, because Kaka, he got off a great stun ray. He put the egg onto the cliff above the Roshan pit, but the PA fought away from the egg. He made sure that they weren't going to get tremendous value out of that supernova. He caught out the backlines, killed them one by one, and then kind of re-engaged after the egg had already blown up. But problem is, by then, the Axe was already dealt with. The Batrider kind of got taken out initially by the Roar, so Batrider not having a 4-star there makes it a lot harder for Complexity to initiate, because even though he catches the Invoker, there's that fast Roar to prevent him pulling the Invoker into his team.
There's the Battle Fury up for Chessie. We'll see how much that lone druid can keep up with the farm rate as well overall, Chessie. Obviously not as brilliant as an Nanny Mage being able to jump from camp to camp, but looks like the... Okay, Kaka also wants to go for a Hand of Midas.
Yeah, he wants that level 2 supernova as fast as possible. Tomes of Experience, there's actually one in stock, so would like to see that perhaps being purchased by
Here
Kaka.
Comes Complexity. Limp gets the call, 4-star away, dragging Kaka out of his hiding spot, and Chessie jumps on it. They're going to kill him off before the Nova can hit Kaka. No, they didn't finish the job. They wanted to back out. They thought they were a little bit too deep. Swindles will die with a Roar around. The Chauntress is able to get enough damage to kill him off.
Oh,
so Complexity's initiation not really working
and
out the way they want.
Coming back in too with the relocate.
Oh, yeah, he'll tether away. Chessie keeps his distance, so the tether will work.
It was a great set. House saves the Phoenix there with the Savage Roar onto Chessie. Complexity just... It looked like Chessie was going to be able to finish off the Phoenix kill with the silence and the stun coming out of Earth Spirit. Kaka was in all sorts of trouble, but a great Savage Roar.
They're going in deeper, and Chessie, he just initiates. He runs in, he goes over on Mu. He'll need a little bit of help. The tether will be there from Hanskin. Now with a ball forward from Z-Freak, he turns on the Magnetize, but there's no real target focus here from Complexity. It's almost like they're trying to kill off all of newbie at the same time, which obviously will not be effective. Not without a whole bunch of crits coming in from Chessie.
Sunray used, time to disengage for newbie. No Roar, no Sunray for a little bit.
No secondary bear either if they lose that.
They'll back off some and be happy with the one pickoff onto Swindle's Batrider.
I actually thought newbie was going to get a lot more from that fight. I suppose they still get space and time.
Yeah. They had to commit their Roar and Supernova to the initial fight under their tier 1 tower where they killed the Bat, so the follow-up fight they just didn't have those key ultimates, and the PA looked like she might have been in some trouble when Chessie initiated in, but the Sunray being slightly on cooldown meant that he could get away with that aggression.
I'm surprised they backed up as well. Was it just because Chessie was slowed down? Like, was it the Fire Spirits that actually slowed him down?
Yeah, he's had... The Fire Spirits are really starting to plague him a bit in these fights, and Phoenix is actually, maxing out the Fire Spirits, only sticking with the one point in the Icarus dive.
That's only going to be the case until Chessie finishes this BKB, and he just picked up the Yoga Club.
Yeah, as he has to, so makes the logical item choice to fight into the Phoenix, the Invoker. I mean, all these heroes you need a BKB against to some extent. The Beastmaster has the Roar to go through, the Enchantress has Impetus, but there's enough other annoying spells that BKB becomes essential for Chessie.
Another thing which we were flagging during the drafting phase is the use of 4-staffs. We've already seen it being a little bit useful. Now you've got double 4-staffs, both Swindle as well as Limp. I picked up early 4-staffs, trying to kite out against newbie.
Yep. Well, Mu has one himself, so that's going to help a lot against the PA, but Batrider, when he catches someone, can pull him very far back.
Yeah, just get that advantage position. It's wonderful seeing 860 crits over on a boar. this is such a scary thing to play up against as well. It's also that, like, we talk about Complexity being the king of random kind of thing. You never know exactly what you're going to get. And now Limp, while he engages to drag the bear back a little bit further, they know it's still, like, it's the last bear. Tornado's going to miss, so there's no control from that, but the Roar will be there. Swindles push back a little bit from it as well. Now they get a good position Nova in the middle of Complexity without heroes, which are really good at clearing it off. Chessie has to one charge and try and get away. In fact, Z-Freak kicked him out to safety, and now they lose two. Complexity, this isn't the fight they were really searching for. But with the help of Hanskin, Chessie will disengage, but now they lose their tier 2.
just the tiniest little details make that fight go Newbie's way. KP gets the Roar off before Swindles can lasso him. Swindles tried to blink on KP. If he gets the lasso before Roar, that fight goes entirely different. And similarly, Kaka landing Fire Spirits on everyone. He just gets a supernova smack dab next to the PA. PA can't even hit it because of the Fire Spirits, I believe, being maxed out. And
yep,
the Midas paying off there. Level 2 supernova. I'm not sure if he had level 2 for that fight. He is level 11 now. I assume he probably was level 11 when he went for that supernova, and they weren't even close to killing the egg.
Oh, Chessy, is this one way they can get some revenge? They're going to find Hal trying to farm up the Ancients, but nope, Savage Roar is available.
Has got Phoenix here too for a potential Sunray.
Yep. All right, so now your Complexity. Newbie of looking very, very powerful. They've taken a lot of good fights. They're pushed the net worth advantage up, even if they haven't got the advantage and experience just yet.
Yep.
Do you try and slow the game up, or do you just say, you know what, we've got to go more hyper-aggressive. We've got to get on the Blink Daggers and fight. What's the play?
You get your BKBs and then get aggressive, I think has to be the approach here. PA as well as Axe both need BKB. The Axe, yeah, he's not a right-clicking hero, but you want to have as many tools to kill this egg as possible. And just being able to BKB off the Fire Spirits means the Axe has a better chance of helping kill the egg. Also means he's not going to get crippled by the Tornado EMP coming out from Mu. I think it's BKBs, then go from the side of Complexity. And they're hoping that they have those double BKBs before the next Roshan is up. It looks like PA should. Yeah, PA will definitely have a BKB. Axe is a little bit further away.
Yeah. I'm wondering if two of Swindles wants to go directly for that.
I believe he should. He's going to pick up a gem for now. He may just be thinking about having buyback, having the gem. He's a much further away, but BKB is really the best item choice for him.
It's a Newbie group up. Looks like another smoke maneuver to come from Newbie. There she blows.
Yep.
And they're headed in towards the Dire Jungle.
There's a lot. No one showing the map, no one defending mid. This is one of those smokes which could be a little bit apparent for Complexity.
They see one. They see Z-Freak, but Z-Freak also saw the Hawk. He's been doing a really good job. He actually took out that first Hawk before. Okay, Z-Freak to the trees. Run away. He needs to Boulder right now. Is that giving me a stun? Oh, Moo! No. Style slide into Tornado. Z-Freak will die. The five-man smoke gank will bring a reward.
And but they're in a position to push high ground at top.
Actually, they have to relocate Chessy back. Chessy doesn't have a TP scroll on him.
Hmm.
And so if you come back, you'll have to relocate him back in, then Hanskin will have to TP back to base.
Yeah, Newbie don't want to force a high ground push, not into the Batrider plus Axe initiation.
He drops some magic wands. They brought a TP on the courier.
Okay,
that's fine. And it brought his BKB as well.
Newbie are kind of hoping for a fast Roshan respawn right now. They found the pickoff on Earth Spirit. If, like,
unlucky, they'll
poke their nose in. I mean, this is...
It's almost 3 minutes.
They would have had to have been very, very lucky to have Roshan up already. But they're going to look to push up bottom, probably sweep through their jungle to get some map control back. I think, ideally, Newbie want to get a gem on someone. Beastmaster wants to pick up his Blink Dagger first, but perhaps someone like Enchantress can buy the gem or the Phoenix. What's Phoenix getting? Just wards for now. So they get some ward sentries. They want to just make sure they have vision around the Roche pick, because right now Radiant Vision is actually very lacking. And with Roche respawning sometime in the next 2 minutes, that's something Newbie have to solve.
Yeah. They also need to know when they're being watched. This Observe Ward, which is, it's going to time out in 1 minute and 22 seconds, which is just before Roshan will spawn up, is seeing the prep from Newbie for Roshan. And Newbie already have good control of the map. Like, they're 4 towers up at the moment. Maybe that's something else we should also look at when you see an advantage of about 3.5k gold and you're still 4 towers up. Maybe not the greatest time in the world. And double BKBs are here for Complexity. Yeah. So they are willing and ready to fight Newbie. And Newbie should be aware that these item timings are approaching. They just may not know they've already arrived.
Yeah, there's a good chance that they've got to know that Chessy's BKB is coming. Perhaps Limps will catch him a bit more by surprise. But
is it actually going to be the full wraparound?
If they can
get up far enough. There's a creep wave coming up in the wave, however, but the smoke's going to break. So here they come, Complexity. In from behind, Limp jumps for the call. Already finds Chorn. They want to get rid of him. The Nova's over in the tree line, too. It's a good position for it. Limp wants to focus it. The Roar helps to bring down Swindles. It's Limp. He just keeps spinning. Have they got enough damage? Z-Freak. Now the silence will come out. But Chessy, he's looking for the kill on Hal. He's battling it, but he won't win. Kaka's Sunray was a little bit too powerful, keeping Hal up. And Z-Freak, now they just keep diving. Complexity. This was meant to be their fight. This was meant to be the dream. But the BKBs don't give them enough.
It was their fight, but Kaka got he reacted so fast with that dive. The second the smoke popped and Newbie is jumping in on them, the Axe blinked past the Phoenix, which was probably the first. I think if Axe goes on the Phoenix,
Complexity can win the fight, but he goes on the back, he goes on the like the core heroes, and then it swindles, trying to blink Lasso the Phoenix, but he dives away too fast, and Kaka wins him that fight. Actually trying to buy some time now, gets saved by a relocate, but Kaka, the hero of that fight, the healing and sustain that he gave his team, as well as the perfectly placed supernova, completely ruined Complexity. What a play coming out from the Phoenix Specialist.
Now, we talk about how Complexity had such great vision across the map. They didn't really have good vision of what was happening over in that tree line. You almost needed a Tinker Ward for Complexity to prepare for that one properly. So it was a bit of like, we hope blind luck.
Yeah.
We hope we find the right target. Now, a big contestant, Complexity, they have to control Roshan. They cannot let Newbie get Negus Immortal as well, or else breaking high ground is going to be even easier for Newbie.
Newbie themselves are going to be well aware of that, and they've got a lot of money to spend on some of these heroes. 4k on Phoenix, 2.4k on Invoker. His Aghanim Scepter almost complete. Phoenix likely see a Shiver's Guard as his key pickup.
Jesse, he's going to get a lot of crits. The bear's coming in. Savage Roar tries to split it up. Roshan's only down by about a third. The Roar is over on Limp. The bear focuses him down 2 on 1. A Nova position inside the pit. They can't even get rid of it. Limp's going to be in a world of hurt right now. The egg will hit the deck. Limp, the BKB trying to protect him. So is Hanskin. But KP as well as Mu, they're all over it. They're going to find 2 quick kills here. The buyback comes out from the eye, but the Sunray. Karka's just working from inside the pit. It's a big fight for Newbie. It is actually a slaughter. Z-Freak has to ball himself away. Hanskin tried to help that. He'll end up just feeding his own life. 4 heroes down, that's including the dieback out from the IO.
Well, 2 fights in a row, Kaka MVP with just how much he does. It's damage output, it's sustain, it's the perfectly placed. He does the most damage of his team while also probably doing all the healing for his team while also controlling the PA in BKB. That supernova stun limits that BKB duration of the PA, and everything about Kaka's performance in these team fights is just impeccable.
That's MVP, that's what it is right now. Newbie looking absolutely amazing, and with that Aegis Immortal, as we said, it's the risky kind of thing that Complexity has to deal with. You now have Howl, the Immortal one, but they're here to take out a bottom Rax, and this will cripple Complexity. I don't know if it's completely beyond repair, but it definitely ain't looking good for the Americans.
Yeah, Kaka can buy a full Shiver's Guard. He's got the recipe on the courier and everything. They're going to go for at least a bottom lane of Rax here. Cole look like they may want to try and engage. They're smoked up. They're trying to catch him on the retreat, knowing that Newbie are likely to TP some heroes back.
Oh, Chessie. The courier's coming in too. Yeah, she takes out the Shiva's Guard as it was flying in. Chessie still has BKB, so he's still going to be willing to fight. But who does he go on? He actually completely leaves out Limp. A great double call. Looking for Kaka and KP. The spins are working. Gets the dunk as well. Complexity. Rebuttal kills as Newbie tried to escape out, but they still lost bottom ranks. They still lost a lot before, so it's almost like a consolation prize. That's why they search for even more, relocating in aggressively onto Newbie. At least Chessie can mop up this tier 1 tower. There's no fortification to stop this, so they get even more out after the fight.
They do reclaim their gem as well. Chessie unfortunately couldn't. I think the Stifling Dagger actually misses Mu in Invis because he gets out of the gem detection range, but Newbie still going to be happy to have taken the full lane of Rax. The big thing, Cole's way to approach a fight has to be initiate on Kaka's Phoenix. Like, catch him either with the lasso or the blink call and then blow him up. PA has to follow it up with a blink and just hope for just a crit to be able to blow the Phoenix up before he can get off any of his spells. Because if they can do that, they win the fight.
Yeah. Oh, at least there's a light at the end of the tunnel for maybe Complexity. The big battling Chessie. The ability to still get good calls off. However, Newbie's lead is definitely stretching well into the stars as Howl gets stronger and stronger and stronger. Top net worth over 20k now for him.
And all three, like the three at the bottom for Complexity are heroes that aren't going to necessarily offer a lot going late game, like Z-Freak's Earth Spirit. I guess he's still useful just because he can be the solution to the Phoenix in some ways. If you catch him out, you can guarantee a stun or a silence to be able to guarantee that he doesn't just dive out of there or even continue to Sunray. So Earth Spirit has to kind of just play around the Phoenix going late game, but Swindles is not going to have a BKB anytime soon, and that's a bit of a worry going into the late game for a Batrider.
I like this item finally arriving over on Hanskin. I wasn't entirely certain who was going to grab it, but it's going to be the Vladimir's Offering now coming in. Normally you see some level of lifesteal over on Chessie, so you have that higher sustain during the fights.
But this will free up Chessy to go for even more damage if he wants to. And he'll need to. Like, it needs to be a Monkey King buff. Battling up against that evasion is making life a little bit more difficult for him.
Yeah, wants to combat the Radiance, but I was thinking maybe a Basher would come out to help deal with the Phoenix, but he's probably just going to have to hope and rely on his team to catch. Realistically, it's just if his team catches the Phoenix, he can help blow the Phoenix up, and the Basher or no Basher won't matter if he has pure damage, so MKB will definitely give him a big boost here. For Newbie, they'll slow things down with the one Rax advantage, probably just pick up. They're going to wait for the Courier. I mean, the Courier has a full Shiver's Guard on it. There's no point to try and smoke out, take a team fight now.
Yeah. You got 10 seconds till that Courier is up, and then travel time.
Yeah. And even, it looks like the Spirit Bear about to pick up an MKB itself, so now they can deal with the PA's evasion on the side of Newbie.
Still wondering, like, who's going to end up winning in that fight? Phantom Assassin versus the Spirit Bear?
I guess depends on the supporting cast, really. Like, it depends on how much the Sunray, how much damage the Sunray can do, whether Chessy will get caught out by the Supernova stun or not,
how many crits you get.
Yep. Newbie is smoking up now. I thought they might want to wait for the Phoenix's level 16, but if he finds a big Midas creep, I guess he can get level 16.
Unfortunately, none of the creeps are spawned up for right now.
Moo, don't block it.
Oh, yeah, and his team is scanning.
Yeah.
I'm not certain exactly who. I think it's Newbie scanning up inside. Actually, no, is that Complexity scanning their own jungle? It seemed a little odd. Volvo, please give us indication of who was actually scanning.
Yeah, both teams just use their scans at like the same time.
Yeah, so there's no way we could actually tell the difference. It's just one scans Dire Sire, the other one scans Radiant Jungle.
Game's in beta, Toby. Just relax.
Alpha. Limp, there's your call. Again, they try and bait this bear in deep so they can get the crits, they get the control. EMP Tornado will actually be used to buy space for the bear, but even then, it's going to go down. They Sunray to keep it alive. So now Sunray's on cooldown, and the bear has to be resummoned.
Man, that's a one way to kill a Spirit Bear very effectively with minimal risk.
How much does it almost feel like a lasso?
Yeah.
it's almost funny. Exactly the same effect as you'd have for a lasso.
Limp is
but all you do is you commit a call, and you commit a 10-second cooldown ability.
Yeah, Limp is like, this is how you play the Batrider Initiator Swindles. Watch and learn. And it's better he initiates, because he's the one who's got the BKB to protect him. If Swindles blinks in, he's got no real defensive capabilities.
It's also when you initiate, you get a bonus 40 armor straight away. So if Newbie want to try and fight you,
if they get a roar on Axe, it's like, well, he's super tanky during that roar and likely to survive.
Yep. So Newbie, have to play this carefully. No, wait, we're past the timer. We're past the timer. So no throw push up onto the hill.
Yeah, Newbie possibly will just look to kind of take map control, secure next Roshan, but it's not easy to do that. The gem did go back the way of Complexity, so see, no gem picked up just yet for Newbie. Maybe something they want to consider at this stage when you're the ones pushing out and up another bear catch. Limp.
Yep. Drag him in. Now Swindles. Okay, they do the double drag. Then this is the secondary bear. If they can get rid of this, which they should be able to. In fact, Newbie, they're sacrificing
they're it.
The kick is there and Chessy just goes ham.
They
so now there's
so
no lone druid bear for 34 seconds.
That's okay. They'll have at least, like, it's not like a Complexity can punish a lot for this. Even if they push things out, there'll be one bear before any fight's going to take place.
And you just use the lasso too, yeah. So like bear and lasso up at the same time. Yeah. It's not terrific.
But
it's something. And now, okay. Siphling Dagger, blink up. Yep, they got the ward on the hillside with Z-Freak support. Well, he's looking for the kick. Now flies through, but it won't matter.
Yeah,
when Chessy can get hits like that, that Phoenix dies very, very quickly.
And that's why you want a gem if you're in Newbie's position. That's the kind of pickoff that just shouldn't be given to Complexity, but it happens because that ward
has almost
been
a full duration, too.
Yeah.
Like, it's got 40 seconds left on it.
When you're the ones in control who up a lane of racks, you shouldn't be allowing your opponent to have that kind of vision. So. And I think partly it was in their mind, like, oh, we had the gem for a while. We don't need to get another gem. We at least dewarded enough, but.
Chessy needs to blink strike himself away from this one. Actually, he's going to BKB up.
Yeah, nice
he was in the
BKB
middle of an ice
force.
Wall as well as EMP, so he had to do something.
And Mood's not worried about dying when the PA turns with a BKB because he's got the four staffs. So just forces out a PA BKB, gets it down to a 7-second duration. And that duration will matter the longer this game draws out. You're trying to fight late game into an Invoker with an Aghanim Scepter with a 5-second BKB, you're not going to have much fun.
Newbie are looking for the Observer Ward. They triggered the Necrobooks. They're looking for the Observer Ward, and it just timed out. They didn't have vision of the high ground either, so they fly the Beastmaster Hawk up and be like, wait, what? Is it on this hill? Nope. Is it on any of these hills? Uh-uh.
It's one of those mind games.
Is it back over? Is it over the tree line? Uh-uh. It is gone.
They've scattered every possible position, so at that point they're like...
It's timed out.
Yeah. You know, the PA literally daggered from the low ground onto the high ground, so that only happens with vision, and the only way they get that vision is through wards. They don't have a hawk or anything, or like a night stalker or anything.
The funny thing is, though, like, okay, so you don't find the ward. Now it looks like they're grouping up to go for another smoke, but they do at least have the Gem of True Sight over on Kaka, so they can have a bit of a peek for this. But they don't have Necro Books for a bit. They have to wait another 43 seconds for this. And notice too, KP's build. He's not going for the blink. Going for the refresher orb now after having the blink dagger. So they're going to have that double lockdown, straight initiation with the secondary wave of Necros.
And against the BKBs, this is the right way. It makes him as much of a threat as Kaka, because if you go all in on Kaka, it's the Beastmaster who's going to have two roars to disable both PA as well as the axe during their BKB durations. But
here's Roshan. Whoa. Complexity is smoked up though. They're nearby.
Here we go. Color ready.
Yep. Z-Free puts down the Observer Ward. Watches Hal moving in and out. Of course, Newbie just put down their own Observer Ward on the right hill. So they know that Roshan's there, and they also very much aware of the Chesty. Now with the completed Helm of the Dominator, he's going to be looking for Satanic. He's looking to be immortal, but it also means he can solo Roshan. They have to stay close.
Oh, they caught Swindles with the Tornado. Radiant
epic
damage
can they
as
do
well.
Anything more? Four-star Swindles. No. He doesn't get up on the hillside. Fireflies, the Flame Break, buys in space, but not enough. Not when the rains are there, but Chessy jumps in from behind KP. Perfect roar on Chessy. They're doing so much damage with an over as well. This isn't when Newbie want to fight, but Chessy! Huge miss over on Chuan. The dunk from Limp is too early. Chuan won't die. Chessy's in trouble. He has to blink himself out of the sunray. Kaka trying to wield that huge power. He's looking for the hit. Z-Freak will burn. He'll get one last magnetize off the Impetus damage. Not enough to kill off Hanskin. He'll relocate back out. Chuan, he'll survive through that. And Hanskin, barely TP's out in time.
Could have gone worse for Cole. Could have gone a whole lot worse. Kaka gets another fantastic supernova off. He couldn't quite chase and keep tabs of the PA post supernova with that sunray. Otherwise, he could have almost just finished off the PA alone. And it's still Newbie who come out heavily on top, though. Swindle's getting caught at the start of the fight. PA then getting roared on initiation just meant that Newbie had such an initiation advantage. And that ward on top of the Roshan pick, giving them all the vision they needed to get those initiation spells off.
Life's become a little bit harder, however, for Complexity. Correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, no, I'm not wrong. Kaka as well as KP now have both the gems too.
Yeah.
So maintaining vision control was already difficult for Complexity because of the Beastmaster Hawk, but now it's almost impossible.
Yeah, they can rebuy. There is a gem available to them. So Io, who's 30 gold short, may look to buy one as soon as they can afford it. And against an Invoker with Ghostwalk, I think you want to just make sure you have a gem. You're in the late game. Anytime a gem is available to you against an Invis Hero, even when there's no Invis Heroes, just against wards, you want to have one. Dust and Sentries, they cost... You're just going to keep spending money on them. They're also not entirely reliable. You can BKB, purge off dust. Sentries have limited range, so they should be looking to rebuy gem as soon as possible.
The medic, Kaka.
There's two bears as well for half of this.
That bear's got lifesteal. I don't think he even needed to do the sunray. Limp jumps in. It was really looking for. Remember though, Limp, very, very tanky when he goes for such initiation. And the kick from Z-Freak creates a lot of space. They relocate, save.
And both four staffs are on cooldown. So this is a small window where Swindles can't really go in until he has four stuff again. They've got to wait 10 seconds
before they can engage. The bear does the work. There's your jump in with a call over on the bear. They hold him there, but Hanskin back in. That EMP burn. Limp and Hanskin will drop low. The Gabal charge, the one charge for Swindles roared up. He won't survive for this one. In comes Kaka again into the Nova. The call is perfect from Limp, however. Watch the spins go. He needs to, however, get these bigger dunks. The bear is out for Kaka. The supernova hits the perfect time. Now isolating Limp on the front lines. Another call, but the damage from Chuan. He just sits at the back lines doing it all. They need more damage here, and Chessy's not providing, especially when he's entangled. Has to Phantom Strike himself away to Hanskin, who's deeper inside the base. Z-Freak again with the Magnetize. Pushes himself away with his own boulder. He'll end up surviving yet. Earn as well as Radiant Burn on him, and Chessy, he'll break the Aegis Immortal, but he's in deep with no BKB charge, burning to the sunray. Hanskin can't keep him alive, and this may be the last straw of the dice right now for Complexity. You'll buy back on the PA. He's TPing outside the base. They want to try and fight here with Chessy, but he still has no BKB.
And he's got no follow-up, so if he chases there, he's chasing into three heroes who can just stand their ground and turn and fight to bring him down, so... A costly buyback, but an essential one, because if he doesn't there, the Lone Druid just takes the mid lane of Rax, and
Again, we see Newbie come out on top. There was a nice couple of heroes grouped up for the PA just to cleave on through with crits, but just didn't quite have the sustain he needed, and Chessy has got to just complete that Satanic as soon as he can to give him that extra bit of oomph in these team fights.
Is that really like enough oomph though? Like, don't you need more damage at this point? It's,
I guess sustain in theory gives you damage because it kind of, if you stay alive longer, you're dishing out more damage, but he's often being controlled during the Satanic is the problem. A 5 second BKB makes his life very rough. But I think having refresh, he's got 300-ish damage, and with crits, it's very big. So I think Satanic works, but he picks up a Blade of Alacrity for now, so. What does this mean? Defusal, perhaps?
Yeah, that's
Defusal
where my mind first went.
Defusal against the Ghost Scepter on
Manta
the
Manta at least
druid.
Let him break free of things like Entangle and
yeah.
such.
There's two Ghost Scepters on the side of Newbie, so. What did
yeah,
he buy?
Defusal. Like, if he's going to find those kills on Lone Druid as well as over on Enchantress, yeah, it's a full Defusal Blade. He needs to inflict the damage. It's still not bad. It still gives him damage, but doesn't give them the survivability you're looking for. But if he does complete up the Satanic, he's still got the increase in HP and potentially just goes to town.
I think one of the rough things for Complexity is they've got these cores who all have BKBs. Oh, I guess Swindles doesn't, but they don't have anyone who can like get Lotus Orbs or Lincolns, because these are the items you ideally want to have against a Beastmaster Roar Initiation, but there's nothing to kind of counterplay it.
Complexity. They smoked on top of the Observer Ward while they're holding a Gem of True Sight. This kind of stuff, it just completely... it's tilt. it's the moment where they've got to keep their minds focused.
Well, they'll get some wards up at least. It's not going to be leading into any kind of kills, I imagine.
No, Newbie just back off the map. They let the bear do the scouting for them.
And Cheese on Howl for the next fight still, so Aegis may have been consumed, but a refresher.
Yeah, there's the double roars.
And Phoenix refresher. Oh my gosh, what? What is happening? This supernova from Kaka has been the big spell in all these fights, and there's going to be two of them. He can refresh it. Sunray, which is also a really high impact spell, and I don't know. It's just so difficult because like I kind of talked about earlier, like you've got to initiate on Kaka, but now with the double roar, it's not as simple as just saying, oh, go on Kaka, blow him up, because Beastmaster will then roar the PA, roar, be it the bat or the axe, whoever initiates on Kaka is likely to get roared, and then you just save the second one for the PA BKB.
This is a huge fight. If they can kill off PA as well, he used buyback previously, yes. So Chessie's death timer is going to be even longer. This is why Chessie just had to buy out practically.
As
Swindles, yep, gets away, maybe even into Firefly. Now he'll trigger it, then yep, they make a break. They
just
get away from Newbie.
KP was mid-roar animation on the axe when he blinks out of there. And for Complexity, so talked about the way they have to approach this fight is to kind of split their initiation tools across the two core heroes in the Phoenix and the Beastmaster. These are the two heroes who win fights for Newbie. So if you can get a lasso on one and a blink call on the other, and then whichever one PA goes on, you kill. You don't have to kill both. You just have to disable both while PA kills off one. And I think ideally, it doesn't matter too much which one you kill. Probably you prefer to kill the Phoenix of Kaka. But as long as you take out either Phoenix or Beastmaster and before they use a spell, you can win the fight if you're Complexity.
Yep. Instead of focusing Bear.
Yeah, you got to try and ignore and bypass the Bear. But that's why we're talking about Blink initiations from an Axe and a Batrider against a Radiance Bear. Not easy to do.
Yeah. You almost actually need to take out the Bear so you can do it. But at that point, defuse your initiation. All right. So mid lane. Ranger melee racks. Can Newbie, do they feel confident to go up? You can see Complexity, they're trying to curve around the sides all the time, looking for some kind of side opening, but now Newbie actually split themselves up a little bit. They push Howl to the top lane, and the other four are waiting for the jump. Chessie's the man who's exposed in the front lines. You've still got four stars. Slim gets the call. They want to drag Mu back in further to the kick. Actually stopping Kanka in the middle of his Icarus dive. Z-Freak also pulling it back, getting the follow-up silence. But the trouble is top lane. Yep. Howl is already attacking into that melee Rax.
They disengage mid while doing damage to the top lane, so Newbie playing very patient, calculated.
That hit from Z-Freak,
right,
that really stopped.
Oh yeah,
because they would have lost top racks if Newbie got the initiation off.
And I think if Complexity initiate off of that Z-Freak boulder smash, they could have won the fight at mid, but it may have been like we won mid fight, but we lost top racks kind of situation.
Yeah,
so Complexity didn't want to engage while the bear was doing what he was up top.
Yeah, Newbie would be very happy if they take the top racks for a couple of heroes' death. You currently have a 22k advantage. in gold and about like 8.5k worth of experience. You're looking very, very calm, collective, and in control of this game. And they don't need to make the mistakes. That was something which has been happening in their games yesterday. Maybe over the night too, they just talk to each other and say, you know what, let's just chill out. Let's just calm down. And the scariest thing is you've got five heroes who are all going to be late game impact, like all going to have late game impact. Your two supports are both sitting on 12k and 15k net worth respectively.
Okay, maybe someone could also kill off Hal. Swindles? Yep, he's going to find him. Hal's out. Oh no! Oh boy! Swindles like blinked just a little bit too far to the side. Yeah. He didn't hit the flame break. He didn't hit the lasso, and the Savage Roar kept him out.
It's been kind of the story of this game. Swindles just slightly missing these initiations. It's not the first time we've seen it. And now
it's
Hanskin. Yep, that's a freebie.
Oh boy. Complexity. That one moment, if they killed off the lone druid, that have some breathing room. They may have actually felt confident enough to push out. But now there's no IO for 50 seconds. You do have that Satanic over on Chessie, so we're sustaining the fight, it's going to be better. And in 30 seconds time, he can buy back. But for now, well, he gets the crit over on the bear, limp in trouble, the kick, tries to buy space, able to do so, but the EMP burn, that damage is enough. Chessie's still going for the bear, but with the Nova going down, Chessie falling quickly, Chessie will die. And now they're down, Swindles can't get the initiation. The bear's even surviving secondary Nova. Complexity, watch them burn right now. They're just going to die. KP's on the back of Swindles, running him into the base. You've lost your mid-racks, your top will die as well. And Complexity, they got one foot in the grave when they're basically climbing in as well. Chessie needs crits, but right now he's even getting bashed up by the bear. Entangled as well, controlled, the Nova is out. Chorn surviving while the rest of Complexity is three men on Chorn right now and they still can't kill the man. Kaka, even he's having fun. They can't find a damn kill until now. Chorn will finally die. Moose also, do they have reveal? Nope, Moose hiding in the tree lines. Crit, not even there. Flame break too late. They may be able to kill off the bear. No, that's not even possible. You're Moose,
they haven't scouted him. Oh. They're pinging him.
Do they know?
Yes.
Okay, Swindles has got the gem. They'll kill Moo. It's a consolation
prize. Moo might get a kill here.
But right now, okay, will he? Yeah, he does. And flame break down. No way. He doesn't get more than that. The flame break will tick him out.
It's mega creeps. Everyone has buybacks. You're not worried about, if you're newbie, about losing much here. At most, you have to use one buyback on an invoker, but Cole are going to push out so incredibly slow. They had to commit a PA buyback. There is realistically no way back for Complexity at this point here, other than some miraculous play. And there's tier two towers to go through. Newbie won't even have to use a single buyback, it looks like.
Nope. No, you don't even care about tier twos, tier threes or not. Fortification as well. You save all your money.
Hal does have no bear, it looks like, which is a bit of a problem, actually.
30 seconds on cooldown.
He'll have only one bear, too, which means... Okay, so a bit problematic. Possible invoker buyback to be forced
this
out.
This actually has to be it. Like, Swindles will BTM when the time is right. He's farming up the remainder of his Lincoln Spear at the moment, so he can come and join the fight for Complexity. They need to be able to open up these Tier 4 towers or find some kind of opening on a hero.
Or if Invoker can hold on to his buyback.
Here's the TP, they're coming for it. Swindles forward, they find the kill over on KP. He's down for 72 seconds, but buyback is available. Complexity, they may just be happy with this. The Tornado over, picking up the Phantom Assassin. Where is your attack? There's no BKB over on this PA. She doesn't have any kind of immunity. And now you're actually losing two. That should be the game right there. Two heroes down for 2 minutes, the big cause. And you don't have any racks, you're Megged. And that is the game. Newbie will take game number one up against Complexity here in the best of three. Lower bracket, first final. Yeah.
Not really sure what happened to Chessie's BKB at the end, man. I'm just clicking like, oh, he doesn't have a BKB, but either way, they were in a desperate position up against Mega Creeps. Newbie just team fought so incredibly well. They had too many answers to like the PA as well as the initiation. Every single time we saw a bat attempt to blink lasso in or the axe blink call, there's a roar there. Yep. And then later on, there was a secondary roar to follow up onto the PA. Kaka on the Phoenix. What more needs to be said as well? That guy just an absolute monster.
Great to see him stepping up to the plate as well. We've seen Chuan be a big highlight of the group stages. His initiation was always amazing. And now you have Kaka in the spotlight, in the sunlight, yep. Looking absolutely amazing. I can't wait to see more from this newbie team. They look a lot better.